got to get done, yeah. It's just something about a good old flood. Watching that red clay turn to mud. Sling it up, slap past the doors like a new paint job on a 4x4.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Tonight's matchup features two quarterbacks who will be trying to lead their teams to victory. It's the Panthers going up against the Falcons. Set for the call of this Week 8 matchup, let's bring in our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Well, there's a new building set to open adjacent to us to the south, but for now, they're still playing football at the Georgia Dome, and that's where we're located here in downtown Atlanta. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Carolina Panthers and the Atlanta Falcons. They come up in an offset eye. Now a first down throw for Newton. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll make it a second down. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
Play clock winding down. Here's Newton now on second down. He'll find his man on the comeback route. Complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Good use of the pass there to pick up the first down against a defensive look that they had specifically prepared for, they told us, coming into this one.
Certainly seems like they're holding all the right cards now, doesn't it? Because of their preparation. Went back, watched the tape, studied the tendencies, and they feel like they had them down cold, and they were able to use the pass against them.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch. Especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Ooh, I like it.
Newton throwing again. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. 18 yards the gain for number 18. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
Now they'll run it on the toss. Looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
For those who watch the game and want to question the courage of the guys who play on the corner, how about when you see a toss sweep coming your way, yet you still go into the backfield, get past the blockers, and make the tackle? That's big league.
Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. And when this offense is clicking on all cylinders, the running back is in sync as well.
The focal point. Runs, catches, blocks, sets the tone for the offense.
And ready for third and six. They'll run it now out of the gun. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave them with a fourth down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it's the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
So they come into enemy territory. Nice drive to start the game, but they probably wanted six. They only got three.
I agree with you totally. That's the expectation. When you get the ball and you start moving it and you're rolling, you think you're going to end up in the end zone. But they should be happy with the three. A good way to get things going here in this game.
First time with Devontae Freeman. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. And a man, as we look at the starters now, a man who really has earned us talking about him in the booth, Julio Jones.
He's a 1,000-yard receiver each and every year. So sleek, so wonderful. I call him Secretariat.
Let's go!
They'll drop to throw. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36.
Well, in that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
So third down, they need to get to the 28 for a first. Throwing on third down, Newton. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential. But when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Newton now to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Tight end right. Tight end right. Three down.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A great play there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers add on to their lead. He's got it, and now it's a 10-0 lead here in the opening quarter. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Shaq Thompson from his outside linebacker spot, forcing the sack for a loss of 8. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you. You change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest...
And got his man complete. And now look at this. Big game, but a fumble. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for 6.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened.
And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They come up with exactly 1 minute to go in this first quarter. They'll come out in the pistol. Going to give this time to the tailback. A strong, and now a fumble. The ball's out, and the Falcons grab it. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Good work. I like it, though, because you're exactly
you
right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long. They've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
He'll look to throw. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's 3rd down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game. Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number 2. They've got a 2nd down and 8 to start things out.
Here we go now.
Again, they'll run with Freeman. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
Partner into the 2nd quarter, and I guess you can kind of look at it both ways. The offense, they've got to figure out what they're going to do because they haven't scored any points. But if you're the defense, you're feeling great about what you've got going on. The only concern you have, if you get to the half, what adjustments will the offense make to try to defeat you?
Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. So 4th and 15, but the offense is staying out there to go for it. And now a whistle and a timeout called by the kicking team. That's their 2nd, so they'll have 1 remaining here in this 2nd quarter. We'll be right back. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. Carolina getting set to take the field. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. Time running out here on the play clock. And he'll give it here to his running back. And strong running there gets this up over the 15-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. And they'll run it here. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL. And a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses. And now we're seeing it in the NFL. Those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one. And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And out of bounds. This will depend on where they spot it. And they'll say at the 45. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But we got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game. I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
They'll look to throw here. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Watch tight end. Watch tight end. Tight end's right. Tight end's right. All right, here we go. Green, 39.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And it's hauled in by Austin Hooper. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. It'll be a loss of 10. And it'll bring up second.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
He's got his man on the crossing route. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. They'll go to the air here on third and 2. And that is incomplete.
And that was a nice play. He knocked it away, but obviously you want the interception in this situation. You want to take away any chance that they have any decision to make on fourth down. But things happen so quickly in the end zone in this compressed area of the field that you're just happy to knock it away and not allow a touchdown.
And the 13-year man puts it through, and they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. So they were able to move the ball into the red zone, but they'll wind up coming away with just 3.
Yeah, 32-yarder. That's equal to an extra point nowadays, and those are no problem for an NFL kicker.
Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. They come out here in the eye. Here's Newton now on second down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
I think we need to come up with a different name for this position. We keep calling it the fullback position. That doesn't necessarily mean it's a fullback, but we know this. Whoever's coming out of that spot is usually bigger and stronger, and they may not run away from people, but they'll run through them.
Yeah, able to shed tacklers. We saw it right there. Newton on third down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. A big play there with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. And it's up and good. The Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player. It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
So third and seven and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
They'll set up a throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Oh, man. For him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight. And the offense moving quickly to the line.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage. And we're still in the second quarter.
Now they try the right side here. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on third and six. So the offense dealing with a third and six. Throwing on third down, Newton. Looking left side, he's got it, complete. Now whistles come in, we're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. They come up in an offset eye. Now a handoff here to his running back. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. They're going to hurry back to the line now. To throw on 2nd down is Newton. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
I wouldn't be shocked at all right now because a look of surprise on the big fella's face because he had the route that he wanted, running the corner. And usually he's able to use his body and catch the football. But a really nice play by the defenders, able to knock it away.
Again, we'll see the pistol here. Trying a little razzle-dazzle on 3rd and short. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Here's Jacob Shum now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. So we are at halftime here on Halloween, as we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. That'll be taken in the end zone. Fighting him off.
Just ran right through the trash.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve.
And while that play was unsuccessful to start the 2nd half, I'm not sure that you just totally abandon what you do running the football. Maybe you make some adjustments in your run game and do things a little bit differently. That doesn't necessarily mean you just go to the pass and do nothing else.
Now they go screen. It's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Give him 6 on the screen, but now it's 3rd down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver, and it's 4th down.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the 5. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line. A look at the offense now here coming back out on the road for their first possession of the 2nd half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
How about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. And he'll find some room to get this up to about the 14. Just what you want on a 1st down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2. See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They come out here in the eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 12-yard line. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down.
Oftentimes when a guy has a game like this, he's going to take his offensive line out to dinner afterwards. But after a play like that, he may tell him, Instead of getting the steaks, guys, we might have to go for the hot dogs.
They brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on third and three.
Good call.
Newton now to throw. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. And they're going to get the first down here across the 15-yard line. A gain of four that time as the drive continues.
And they pick up a first down, and that came out of the fullback position. But as you and I both know, that doesn't necessarily mean it's a fullback playing in that spot.
Well, times have changed, right? The old-school fullback doesn't really exist anymore.
We're not getting that same player out of college. With all the spread offenses, not very many pro style, where you actually have a true fullback, we're having to make do in the NFL and put guys in that spot who emulate it but aren't necessarily that position.
A good convergence there defensively, only a yard, and it's second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed, but all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Second down now after the pass completion. Second down, here's Newton. Going right side here, and that's complete. 15 yards there on the catch and run.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man. Because